Huh? I've never been so pleased at the sight of an open door. Please tell me you've cleared a way out of here. So you have. I am much obliged. And now, if you do not mind, I have had quite enough of this wretched place. Oh, really? And why, pray tell, would I do a thing like that? Your point is well taken. I would rather not spend the rest of my days looking over my shoulder for the shadow of my headhunter. Here, take the damned research. Tell Crane I hope he chokes on it.
I can take a hint. Oh, look at how big she is. Wow. We're not going in there. Here they come. Nice and easy.
Yeah, huh? Sure thing, Captain. I'll be waiting back at the Unreliable if you need me. Something on your mind? Okay, see you around.
Thank you. Seriously, don't get yourself killed. It's a nice cigarette case, but it's still just a cigarette case.
It's kind of a collectible, like one of them cereal box toys.
You damn turncoat. We saw everything.
You must think me a fool. I was watching on the security cameras. You got downright friendly with the outlaw leader. I reckon we got nothing to say to each other. You best back yourself out of here. Nice and slow. You got 1 minute. Starting now. You convinced her to let us leave in peace. Listing the ills we've been done ain't exactly putting me in a mind to compromise. Don't reckon the company's gonna see it that way. Think I don't know my own responsibilities, mister? I reckon I don't see any better solution. Fine, damn it. We'll pull out. Here, my key card. It'll get you access to the whole place. Full stakes, people. We're heading back to town.
Thank you.
picked the wrong damn day.
Thank you.
Seriously, don't get yourself killed. It's a nice cigarette case, but it's still just a cigarette case.
You're shitting me. You ain't so bad. Here's something for the trouble.
lab. What's left there that's worth dying for?
You let them get away. Worthless, the lot of you.
Well, you get what you pay for, don't you?
That no-account fool Porter and his crew are even more worthless than I could have imagined. They've abandoned their posts. This is madness. Jameson. I didn't do right by him, did I? Only cared about how he helped or hurt my research. Not here in this colony, there isn't. Outside Byzantium, life is worthless, without meaning. I must get there. You've returned. What news? Please tell me you've recovered my research. Without my work to focus on, I find myself tending towards darker paths of inquiry. My research? Please tell me you've recovered it. That's... You can't possibly understand the enormity of what you've done for me. And what, pray tell, is the status of our Raptodons? Capital. Excellent. If we're done here, I'd like to get back to work. You understand. Actually, there is something else. Why do you suppose Auntie Cleo's would want to market diet toothpaste to the lower classes? Yes, but that doesn't quite ring true. There's something amiss here. It nags at me like a sore tooth, but I can't for the life of me figure out why. By the architect, this could be a disaster. Why did I not realize that? I would love to argue with you, but I fear you are correct. All I cared about before was Byzantium. I believed getting there was everything, that my life would finally have meaning. Thank you.
Oh, your face is a sight for sore ocular processors, Captain. Or rather, your headgear is. We've arrived at the Groundbreaker.
All I'm saying is, our lives are predestined upon a path that is only visible in retrospect. If I could have predicted my life path would lead to prison, and thus avoided it, wouldn't I have done so? And even if I had, it still would have been unavoidable. Like that time I warned you about the giant pile of Raptodon shit, and you stepped in it anyway. You see?
Hey, be careful with those crates, huh? My cargo's worth a lot of money.
Well, you probably should have insured it.
This is Halcyon News. We interrupt your regular...
Rizzo's Lemon Slap. Slap your whole family tonight.
Had a moment to look into that little opportunity I told you about on Roseway. You don't hurry up. Someone will get to snooping around there before you do. What's that? Speak up now. What'd you turn up? Pardon me, sweetheart. My old ears must have misheard you. Did you say Raptodon? Gracious, someone must have hauled them off Monarch. Naughty, naughty. A couple of folks around here might pay a fair few bits for this. Might even be able to start a bidding war. Well, that's just swell, sweetheart. Good for you. Are you positive? Honest to goodness? Can't say I wasn't hoping for more, but I suppose it can't be helped. Law bless you for doing the legwork, sweetie. Don't forget your pal Gladys now. You can come visit anytime. Fantastic. Do be careful with it, dear, as these keys tend to be a tad hard to acquire. You should have a chat with Lilia Hagen in the sublight offices. She's a tier. You'll love her. Now, was there anything else? What do you want, then? My hard-earned wisdom? Ask the common folk, and they'll tell you it's on account of all the monsters on Monarch desperate to gobble you up. Because that's what the board tells them, you see. I think they made some fool mistake that would make them look bad to the rest of the colony, and they're trying to hide the evidence. Those board folk are real prideful-like. Never want you looking behind the curtain, lest you see their derrieres. But old Gladys knows the score. The whole colony's not much more than a diorama, showcasing one board screw-up after another. That's why we gotta keep them from getting their grubby mitts on Groundbreaker. She's our mess. Probably. Every once in a while, we get these snippets of radio chatter. Edna shows them to me. Some man hooting and hollering about the light in us all. Claims he's transmitting from Monarch, but who knows if that's true. Might be true. Might be some new trick from the board. Anytime, sweetheart. You know where to find me. Here, take a candy with you.
C&P Borst Worst. It's not the worst unless it's Borst Worst.
Didn't the board rep's office used to be in the docking bays?
Yeah, about 10 years back. That was before Medford.
So, how's this work? Do we get a table? Stand in a corner?
Tossball finals are scheduled.
Okay, so what are we drinking? You're the expert. Oh, and don't worry on the price. I got this. Let's just do it proper. Oh, no, that's on account of my not being able to sleep lately. Makes my hands all twitchy, you know? I've just been lying awake, thinking about what June Lei said, and feeling my heart shake. Oh! Beer. I guess, yeah, I can do that. Beer can be good. I bet. Bottoms up.
Think of it like a fizzy tea that's gone a little off.
Ah, this tastes like the underside of a boot. People drink that for fun? Oh, Captain, I'm pining for June like something fierce. What am I doing?
You're funny.
Yeah, I guess we're doing that, aren't we? Crewing together, seeing the stars. It's like something out of a serial. I like the ones with grand romances. And I think I'm flubbing mine. I don't know what to do about us. Well, she talked about another girl, right? Isabel. Mentioned her by name and everything, like she wanted me to know. Maybe I've been making a right fool of myself this whole time. Maybe she's not interested after all.
Exactly. Takes a lot of trust to hand over that kind of blackmail material.
I don't know, I'd call it, sensual. That's a lot. It. Oh dear, I hadn't really. Oh my goodness. And I told you?
Let's read it right now, just to be sure.
You know, that's a given, Captain. I can't not worry myself to bits about the things that matter to me. It was real long and rambly. She was telling me a story about her dad, how lady named Isabel did all sorts of things to try to win his favor. This Isabel lady never quite managed to get her dad's approval, but they carried on anyways. Made something good out of a bad situation. Then it all went down the tubes. Do you think June Lei still has feelings for her? I just got a lot of feelings, Captain, and they're all climbing up my throat. I need another drink. Right now. Before I lose my nerve.
Come on, Captain! I'm here to drink!
Okay, maybe you're right. I am a little woozy. Hydration, here I come.
Aw, this was just about to get fun.
Shush you. Oh, Captain, I want to talk to June Lei all the time. Even about silly things, but I'm so scared. Everything? I got a solar system's worth of terrifying questions swirling around my head. Does she think I'm as pretty as I think she's handsome? What if she doesn't like me? What if she does? What if she's still got feelings for that lady, Isabel? What if we get together and she gets bored of me? There's nothing easy about spilling your guts to the person who's got your heart in their hands. You know I'm not interested in physical affection. That's... Well, it's tripped folks up in the past. Folks I thought cared about me for me. What if she's not okay with that? What if she is, but then later, she's not? What do you mean, Captain? So I should just be myself? You sound like my dad. It's sweet. Gosh, I don't know that I got that in me. Sometimes I feel real mean inside, Captain. I think ungenerous thoughts. Well, I suppose so, but I want to be my best self for her. A good person, worth caring for. Well, Captain, this has been a whole lot. I got just... wow. So much to think about. Oh, gosh. I don't know, Captain. Do you think I should? All right.
There's no need to strip your screws over it.
Okay. I'm gonna do it. I'm gonna ask June out. Just as soon as we get back to the ship. I mean, probably. Eventually. Thanks for hearing me out and giving me counsel. And, well, for being a friend. It means a whole lot. You're good people, Captain.
This was fun. We should do it again after you send that message.
Oh, all right. Thank you, guys. You're real good friends, you know that? I wish there was a place we could all live quiet together. Come on, let's go.
Rizzo's Knock You Out Bar, a CCN 76 on the bar. Three notes in it. It's time for
Dr. Ellie. You ever wonder if maybe we got some things in common? This isn't another thing about wrenches and guns, is it? Because you're a surgeon and I'm a mechanic. We both fix things, heal them up. Hate to break it to you, but before I got to Groundbreaker, I fixed more noses than bones. Nowadays, I probably shoot more than I save. Oh.
You see, we had a conveyor pull in? One of them interstellar jobs.
Hard to miss something that big.